By 1881, Allen Street had over 106 saloons. 106 saloons plus on one street. I don't know about you folks, but to me, that sounds like heaven. But it's also a recipe for disaster, too. Think about it. You got 106 saloons. You got a few hundred drunk cowboys, all of which are armed. You do not have to be a great mathematician here, I hope, to figure out the end result. Chaos and mayhem. A little population control going on here in Tombstone 120 some odd years ago. Now, as far as the red light district was concerned, that too was big business. The red light district began at the Birdcage Theater. It ran 8 blocks long and 2 blocks deep. By 1882, Tombstone had 3,400 registered ladies of the night. 3,400. Sounds like fun. We know that number to be true. I use the word registered. You see, to be a lady of the night back then, you actually had to go to City Hall. And you had to pay a fee for a license. So even the city of Tombstone made money off them shady ladies. God bless them. Now this town, first and foremost, we were indeed a mining den. Made possible thanks to silver in the ground. Today we're Arizona's second biggest tourist attraction. Second to that big ditch over there they call the Grand Canyon. People do not fly from all around the world to come to Tombstone and look at a silver nugget. This town was put on the map and is still here today thanks to bloodshed. You folks are all here today thanks to bloodshed. That makes you twisted individuals. But that's okay, because so am I. But today for you folks, we're going to do 5 historical reenactments. That is referred to as the bloodiest quarter in America, right up here. Nearly 70 men lost their lives right up there. It involves 2 good friends of Bat Masters playing a game of cards at the Oriental Saloon. Now you all met Charlie Storms, now meet his opponent, Luke Short. Howdy boys.
Howdy Bat.
Mind if I join you?
Sure, play a little poker. You bring some money?
I got money.
You're gonna need a lot more sitting next to this man right here.
As you can tell, Pat, Mr. Storms here be on Bevelu Street, been belly aching all morning long.
Hey, Short, I got an epiphany for you. How about you just shut up and play some cards?
Charlie, I figured you of all people would be used to a losing streak.
No.
You've been on a losing streak since what, birth?
Don't remind me.
Can't live forever, kid.
How many cards you need there, Charlie?
3.
3. There it is. How about you, Bat?
Give me 2.
There you go. Bet you there, Storm.
I'll call you.
All right. What do you got?
Pair of 5s.
Pair of 5s. Felt sorry for my pair of 9s.
4 coins, boys.
What did I tell you, Bat? All morning long, he's been pulling off the bottom.
You want to try and get a little sick tiger left for ourselves right now? We can do it.
Ease up, boys. You guys start getting away like it's the 4th of July, and I'm stuck in the middle.
Bet you there, Charlie.
Not sure. Think I'm only gonna need to take 1.
Just 1. Maybe that losing streak yours changed. How about you, Bat?
Huh?
Play cards to me.
Can I get 5?
Yeah, I'll give you 5, then I'll shoot you.
You need 3.
3 it is. Bet you there, Storms.
What do you say, boys? All in.
All right, I'll call you what you got.
Random week, boys. 3 aces.
That's pretty good, Charlie. Not good enough. That's where I come from. 3/8 don't make 4/8, boy.
You what? That's 13 hands in a row. Ain't nobody that lucky.
14.
Whatever.
Now calm down, Charlie. Go up to the bar there. I'll buy you a drink. I believe I can afford it now.
How was that helping?
Come on, back to my drink. Boy, I can keep doing it to you. That car sure loved me today, you know what?
Always win.
That's fact, Mr. Bond.
Yeah, that's all funny, short. Car seems to be liking you when you're always doing the dealing.
Got something on your mind, Stormy? Spit it out.
Those slick hands are gonna get you killed.
Go away, chief. Get up here. Oh. All right, turn on me up that door. Looks like I went again, Charlie. Don't worry about the tab. Drinks are on me.
Luke Short, the gentleman and the gambler that he was, after that shooting, he turned around and walked back into the Oriental Saloon. After all, he had a card game to finish. Charlie Storm's here. Well, look at him. Just look at him. Besides being one of Tombstone's first speed bumps. But also appear that Charlie is now the proud owner of some new property. Thanks to Luke Short, that property comes free with a blind box, too, up here in Boudel.